clear what needs to be done to ensure a barrier-free, safe passage of travel for people with disabilities and everybody.
In Toronto, I'm Faiza Amin for City News.
Excuse me.
We are focused on health and happiness, and this is really the motto of our charity. We're here to use meditation techniques to help people gain health, and with health, we can then be happy. But we're here today to actually celebrate Chinese New Year, and it's really a different aspect of what we see with global meditation.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Hester. It's feeling very relaxed indoors, and it's actually pretty decent out there right now as well. Let's switch on over and talk a little bit about weather. Current conditions in Toronto, 1 degree. See that, right? Because I know we've been dealing with some really cool temperatures, so this is definitely welcome news. With the wind chill feeling more like -5, and overnight we're dropping down to about -1, with the wind chill feeling like -7, but still a lot better than what we've been seeing these last couple of weeks. And now there is a risk for freezing drizzle risk overnight, and that will continue on until tomorrow, but in the morning you're starting at about 2 degrees, and it's going to be warming up significantly to about 4 to 5 degrees. Cloudy conditions for the most part, but the temperatures are really nice. The average for the time of -2, so really the 5-degree daytime high, I will take it any day. Now there will be some light winds from the southwest at 20 kilometers an hour, and there is a chance for some freezing drizzle risk throughout the day, so if that is the case, make sure you drive carefully. Coming up, I'll be taking a look at the 7-day forecast.
Here with a Sportsnet Central update. turning point for the team, though, seemed to come on special teams. They were 0-5 on the power play, and though they know it's a point that needs to improve, they insist they're not feeling frustration quite yet.
We have to be better. As a group, I think that's the area that we have to take pride in. I mean, there's nice production, very important. We need to come to the game, and obviously last night, we didn't do a good enough job of capitalizing our opportunities. We certainly had plenty of time on the bar, but you know, it didn't really make it count. So moving forward, we have to get better.
I'm frustrated. I mean, before the break, we're all around the net. We're in chances all around the net. It's just not bouncing in. It's nothing you can do about it. It'll come eventually, and we're just going to stay patient with it.
A couple of Canadian teams playing matinees today. Let's start Philly with the Flyers taking on the Oilers. Late first period, tied at one on the rush. Connor McDavid breaks the 30-goal mark for the third time in four seasons. This one goes to OT, all tied up at four in the extra frame. James Van Riemsdyk wins the battle behind the net. Centers for Nolan Patrick, who buries the overtime winner. Flames vs. Flyers with their seventh straight 5-4. The Canadians also in action. Carey Price, recipient of the Habs January Player of the Month. Not playing today, though. Suspended for this one for skipping All-Star Weekend. Third period, 2-1 Montreal. Kevin Rooney throws it in front. It falls to Nico Hischier. He snaps it past Antti Niemi. This one needs OT as well. In overtime, Hischier through the zone, walks in and beats Niemi on the short side. His second overtime winner of the year.